brought to you by Gitanjali Salon, Channi Himmat, Jammu. Follow Ruchika Makeovers on Facebook and Instagram for best bridal makeup in town.
Hello viewers, you're watching Jammu Links News. I'm Annak Gupta and welcome to the daily updates of Midday News. Let's begin.
The NIA on Monday filed a charge sheet in a special court here against six persons for allegedly helping three terrorists of Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed to infiltrate into the country. On January 31st this year, a truck was stopped for checking by the officials at Bantol Plaza, Nagrota in Jammu on Pathankot-Srinagar Highway at 5 a.m. Three freshly infiltrated Pakistani terrorists were found hiding in the vehicle. The Home Department, Jammu and Kashmir has not issued any orders regarding restoration of 4G internet services in Jammu and Kashmir, said the Department of Information and Public Relations, Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday. The DIPR J&K issued this clarification through its Twitter handle after a fake order copy from the Home Department dated July 27th with directions to internet service providers to lift speed-related restrictions in the Union Territory, which had the name of the Principal Secretary to the Government, Charlene Kabra, began circulating on social media platforms. The Union Territory government has revised COVID-19 management for asymptomatic patients, permitting them home isolation with certain conditions like separate room facility at house, and also allowed rail travelers reaching here the home quarantine after sampling if they have valid contactable telephone number with Arogya Setu application. A decision on home quarantine for air travelers is under consideration of the government and final call will be taken in next few days. India on Wednesday reported 47,704 more COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours, taking the country's count of coronavirus cases to 14,83,157. Out of the total cases, there are 4,96,988 active cases in the country, while the number of patients cured or discharged and migrated stands at 9,52,744. With 654 deaths due to COVID-19 in the country reported in the last 24 hours, the death toll rises to 33,425. The recovery rate among COVID-19 patients has increased to 64.23%. Jammu and Kashmir reported 9 more COVID-19 deaths on Monday, taking their number to 321 as 470 new cases of the infection took the tally in the Union Territory to 18,390. Of the fresh cases, 161 are from Jammu region and 309 are in the Kashmir Valley. There are now 7,667 active cases in Jammu and Kashmir, while 10,402 patients have recovered from the infection. Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu, Chancellor of Sher-e Kashmir University of Agricultural Sciences and Technology of Jammu, visited the main university campus at Chatha on Monday. The Lieutenant Governor inaugurated the new infrastructure blocks, including building of Ujala PG Girls Hostel, residential quarters for teaching staff, and a bedside oxygen facility established at the University Health Center in view of COVID-19 pandemic. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Monday that it was imperative for India to develop coronavirus-specific health infrastructure at a fast pace, and the country now has more than 11,000 COVID facilities and more than 11 lakh isolation beds. Launching the three new high throughput labs of the Indian Council of Medical Research at Noida, Kolkata and Mumbai through video conference, he said the country has only one COVID testing centre in January and there are almost 1,300 such labs now. Central government employees retiring during COVID-19 pandemic will be receiving provisional pension till their regular pension payment order is issued and other official formalities completed. This was stated by Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh. He said, because of the disruption in the official work due to the pandemic and lockdown, some of the employees who had retired during this period may not have been provided with pension payment order. The Jammu and Kashmir administration informed the Supreme Court on Monday that it will not extend the current detention of High Court Bar leader Mia Abdul Qayyum under J&K Public Safety Act beyond August 7th. The top court asked J&K administration to apprise it by July 29th as to why Qayyum cannot be released on bail till August 7th, the day his current detention period expires with certain conditions. Advisor to Lieutenant Governor Farooq Khan on Monday chaired a meeting to review market checking and availability of essential commodities and sacrificial animals in view of Eid al-Adha festival. Speaking on the occasion, Advisor Khan directed Divisional Commissioner Kashmir and IGP Kashmir to ensure strict enforcement of rate lists of sacrificial animals and other essential commodities during the period. It was given out that there is sufficient stock supply in Kashmir with respect to rice, atta, kerosene oil, LPG and other fuel supplies. Financial Commissioner Revenue Dr. Pawan Kotwal visited Kathua and took a detailed review of the ongoing digitization of revenue record and functioning of Revenue Department during a meeting. He informed that out of total 533 so far, 379 Jamabandis have been completed and work on another 102 Jamabandis is in process. He added that so far 42,536 domicile applications have been received all over the district, of which 34,921 domicile certificates have been issued, including 165 of West Pakistani refugees. The Divisional Commissioner Kashmir Pandurang K. Pol on Monday visited Leepur Colony Behrar Lal Bazar to take stock of developmental activities and healthcare facilities provided to the inmates there. The Divisional Commissioner called for formulating proper rehabilitation policy for the Leepur patients and the families. Besides, he also emphasized on providing scholarships to children of Leepur patients for assistance in their studies. He also urged the concerned to ensure timely allocation of residential quarters to all left out families for their comfortable stay. Advisor to Lieutenant Governor K.K. Sharma has said that the micro-industry sector has a tremendous potential to create employment opportunities for the educated unemployed youth of Jammu and Kashmir, besides contributing to the local economy. The advisor was speaking at the Board of Directors meeting of J&K Khadi and Village Industries Board. The advisor directed the board to extend hand-holding to the educated unemployed youth of the UT so that they can avail benefits from various schemes being implemented under the purview of Khadi and Village industry sector. The Jammu and Kashmir government has evacuated about 2,65,687 JK residents stranded in other parts of the country due to COVID lockdown via Lakhanpur and through special trains and buses till date, amid strict observance of all necessary guidelines and stranded operating procedures. As per the official data received in this regard, the Jammu and Kashmir administration has received 96 special trains at Jammu and Udhampur railway stations from different states and UTs so far, with about 80,765 passengers, while about 1,84,922 persons from other states and UTs, including 901 from abroad, have been evacuated by the government through Lakhanpur till date.